Dorothy Ann Davis, and I'm Miss Davis's mama. Even though Miss Davis is cuter than a button, she don't know a prune from a spoon, so she asked me to show y'all a few things in the kitchen today.
Can you please stop talking and just cook something?
Oh, sugar bunches, don't get all bent out of shape. I'm just proud of you.
I'm already having regrets about asking you to be a part of this.
Hey, don't you use that tone with me, young lady. I got you in this world. By God, I take you right on out. Anyways, let's go ahead and get started. Today, we're going to be making a nice fresh salsa straight from the garden. Got a lot of great ingredients over here. Let's go over them real quick together. Tomatoes, they've got vitamin C, K, potassium, and folate. Garlic, that's good for your heart. It can lower cholesterol and blood pressure. Onion, vitamin C, B, and potassium, that prevents muscle cramps. Jalapenos got a little bit of everything. Vitamins A, B, C, the whole stinking alphabet, potassium and folate. Lime's got vitamin C, and corn's got iron and vitamin B, zinc, and a few other things in it that I don't even know. Let's start off by cooking our corn. Corn is one of the easiest things there is to cook, y'all. You can grill it, you can boil it. I like mine with a nice char, but I'm in my nice shirt, so I don't want to get the grill out right now, and I'm just going to boil it today. I put some water right here in this pot. Soon as it starts boiling, I'm just going to drop it right on in there for a few minutes, and it's going to be perfect. The next thing that we're going to be doing is a lot of chopping. That's pretty much what salsa is. It's just chopped up vegetables, so that's all you do to make it. When you're chopping food, you got to be real careful. Knives are sharp, y'all, and they can hurt you. Especially when you first start cooking, you should really have an adult in the kitchen with you. But just be really extra careful. Let me tell you a story. You know, there used to be this woman named Nancy Carter, lived down the street from us a while back. Hey, sugar bunches, do you remember Nancy Carter lived down the street from us?
Who?
Nancy Carter!
Who?
Nancy!
Who?
Anyway, Nancy Carter, I never really liked the gal all that much because she thought she was better than everybody else. Well, one time she had a dinner party. We come over and Nancy's just a-chopping away on some vegetables. She starts carrying on and on about how all of her kids are on the honor roll. All of her kids are star athletes. She wasn't paying no attention to what she was chopping, and before you know it, she chopped off the end of her middle finger. It fell into the stew she was making. All right, y'all, the squash is done cooking. The grapes look good. I went ahead and pulled them on out of the oven, put them in a little bowl, and look how beautiful that is. Now, last thing we gotta do is just add a little bit of that goat cheese. Like I said, just a little, not a lot. Little bit goes a long way. So we're just gonna drizzle a little bit of that over the top here. Maybe a little bit more. Oh, that's plenty right there. All right, last thing to do is give it the old taste test. Let's see. I'm going to get me a grape on here. I'm going to get me a couple pieces of squash. Hopefully it's not going to burn my mouth. It is kind of hot still, but I'll take that risk for you. Y'all, that is so good. It really does make you want to slap your mama.
Why do you always say that about the stuff you cook?
Well, try it, and you'll see what I mean.
Well, this is actually really good. It's, like, really good.
So good it makes you want to slap your mama, doesn't it?
I mean, if you're asking if eating this is making me suddenly feel violent towards you, I would say no.
Hit me!
What?
Hit me! Hit me!
Have you been watching professional wrestling again? I thought that we talked about that, Mom. Was that my t-shirt that you just tore in half?
Hey y'all! Welcome to today's episode of Healthy Cooking with Dorothy Ann. I'm Dorothy Ann Davis. Today we've got a real special episode. Today I'm gonna be having the talk with y'all. You know, that special talk, the one that sometimes makes middle schoolers feel a little awkward.
The talk, as in the talk, like the talk that kids fear having the most with their parents / health teachers.
Oh yeah, the talk. It's about to be had.
No, you're not doing that.
Why not? I'm great at giving the talk. I gave you the talk, now didn't I?
Yeah, and at least half the stuff you told me was totally wrong.
You calling me a liar?
I honestly don't know if you were lying to me or if you genuinely have a lack of understanding about the way things work.
You calling me stupid?
You told me that I was supposed to put deodorant on the bottoms of my feet, so...
Hey, that wasn't bad advice. Putting deodorant on your tootsies kept them from stinking so bad.
My feet didn't stink that bad.
Are you kidding me? Y'all, her feet smelled awful. Her feet used to smell like a combination of a sweaty old football helmet and some old milk.
Oh, please, they did not.
It was kind of like the smell of a dirty diaper covered in burnt hair.
You're being ridiculous.
It stung the nostrils. It's like a litter box that's gone way, way, way too long without being cleaned out.
My feet were fine.
It was like the smell of a wet dog sitting next to a dumpster behind a Taco Bell.
Stop.
You remember that sleepover you went to when you was 8 years old and I had to come pick you up because you took your shoes off and your feet smelled so bad that it made all the other kids cry?
Yes. I also remember agreeing that we were never going to bring that up again.
All the other kids at school called her puke feet after that because her feet smelled so bad and made everybody want puke.
You're a monster.
Anyways, we're going to go ahead and get started with our little talk. Today, I want to talk to y'all about salad.
Wait, you want to talk to them about salad? That's what this is about?
Yeah, what do you think I want to talk to them about?
Nothing. Never mind. You just go ahead and talk about salad with them. Okay, Mom, I'm going to try this again. Repeat after me exactly how I say it. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers.
Peter Piper paid and punched a pukey plumber.
Nope. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers.
Peter Piper poked and popped a perky pimple.
Peter Piper pushed a pack of pooping possums.
Why are the ones you're saying nasty?
Peter Piper passed a plate of parasitic pork. Peter Piper picked up people playing at a party.
Well, way to turn Peter Piper into a creep.
Peter Piper packed a piece of purple pizza. Peter Piper peeled a pair of polished pumpkins. Peter Piper put a pack of peas on pecan pie.
How do you keep coming up with all these?
Peter Piper petted puppies in pajamas. Peter Piper poured piranhas on the pastries. Peter Piper paved the park with paralyzed pigeons.
Do You done?
Yeah, I think I'm done.
You want to show the kids how to make some pickles today?
Yeah! Hey, y'all. Welcome to today's episode of Healthy Cooking with Dorothy Ann. Today, we're going to be making something called bruschetta.
Actually, it's pronounced bruschetta.
Actually, it ain't.
Yeah, it is. Bruschetta is an Italian dish, and in Italy, it is pronounced bruschetta. So that is the correct way to say it.
Does it look like we're in Italy? I suppose next thing you want me to do is start calling Versailles Road, Versailles Road, and Paris, Kentucky, hooray, because that's how they say it in France.
Yes. Also, zebra is actually pronounced zebra. That is how it is said in South Africa, where zebras actually live.
I ain't doing that. I ain't gonna walk around talking like no idiot.
Most people would argue that you already do, but that's fine.
Don't you dare insult the way I speak. I have the accent and the sophistication of a Southern belle.
I really don't know how you have an accent at all. You're from Ohio.
You don't know the first thing about my upbringing. I was raised on a farm and life was hard. I woke up before sunset every day to feed them animals, and then I spent the whole day working in the fields.
You grew up in the suburbs of Columbus, and your father sold kitchen appliances for a living.
I know who I am!
Whatever.
All right, so we just take a spoonful of this. We just put it right on top of our bread there. Like so. I'm gonna put just a little more. Okay, and the final touch is a little bit of this balsamic vinegar. We're just going to put a little bit on the top. Like so. And now it's time to give it an old try. So good. Not only does it taste so good, but it's so good for me.